Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to customize the rows, columns, and cells of the Syncfusion React Pivot Table component. I will also show you a few features like resizing columns and using gridlines, clip mode, a cell template, and selection. Let me open my existing example, where I've installed the Syncfusion React Pivot View package. I have also bound JSON data using the data source property. Let's take a look at the data, bound to the data source. It contains fields like sold, amount, country, product, etc., are mapped to the row, column, and value axes. You can refer to my Getting Started video shared in the card above or in the description below to learn more about local data binding. I'll run this application. See, the pivot table rendered based on a JSON object. Notice the default row height is 36 pixels, the column width is 110 pixels, and the first column width is set to 200 pixels. We can set a custom height using the row height property in grid settings. Let's set its value to 60 pixels. Set the column width to 200 pixels. And I set the height to 500 pixels. Checking the pivot rows and columns, the height and width are customized. You can also resize the column by enabling the allow resizing property in grid settings. Checking now, when I hover over the column border, the resizing icon will appear. I can move it and change the column size. By default, the grid lines are displayed based on the theme. For Bootstrap 5 theme, both horizontal and vertical lines are displayed. In grid settings, include the gridlines property, and I can choose any option like both, none, horizontal, vertical, and default. Here I choose the vertical option. See now, only vertical lines are shown in the pivot table. I'll change the grid option to both for clear understanding. By default, when I shrink a column, the cell content overflows its area, and an ellipsis will be displayed. If you want to truncate the content, add the clip mode property in grid settings and assign the option clip. When I shrink the column size now, overflowing text will be truncated. When I set the clip mode to ellipsis with tooltip, and an ellipsis with tooltip is displayed. You can view only the column header cell tooltip. So, I disable the normal tooltip by including the show tooltip property and set its value to false. When I shrink a column, ellipsis with tooltip is displayed. Next, I will show you how to customize a cell using templates. I want to display a neutral icon in all the cell data except row and column headers. Include the cell template property and assign the callback method customize cell. Inside this method, return the span element with an icon. In the app.css page, define the font family with the name and source. Also, define the styles for the pivot neutral icon with the font family. To avoid displaying icons in the column header, set the display to none for the icon wrapper. Do the same for the row header. Checking now, the neutral icon is displayed in all cell data. Next, I will show you how to select pivot data. To enable selection in a pivot table, add the allow selection property in the grid settings and set its value to true. Check the pivot table, then click any cell, and the entire row will be selected. The other selection modes available are column, cell, and both. To select a column, include selection settings and set the mode property to column. Now, when I click any cell, the entire column will be selected. If the mode option is set to both, I can select both a row and column. Set the mode option to cell. This output shows the result of setting the mode to cell. To select multiple rows, columns, or cells, include the type property and set its value to multiple. Now, I can select a multiple cells. By default, all the cells between the start and end target cells will be selected. This mode is called Flow Cell Selection Mode. To change this mode, include the Cell Selection Mode property and set its value to Box. Checking now, cells between the start and end cells are selected as a box. I can also reorder the column and the pivot table by enabling the allow reordering property in the group settings. Checking now, I can reorder the column header in particular year. Let me comment on the column width property and change the column header with large text. See now, the column header text is overridden. Finally, I will show you how to autofit the columns using the autofit columns method. To call this built-in method, I declare a variable pivot object and specify the component module name as pivot view. Then I include the ref property and assign the pivot object. Add data bound event and assign the callback method autofit. Inside this method, use the pivot object to call the autofit columns method. Check now, columns are adjusted to their header text. To adjust the width of the column, I use the column render event in grid settings. Assign the callback method, columnFit. Inside this method, set the autofit property to true for all columns based on their length. See here, the column's width is adjusted. In this video, you've learned how to customize the rows, columns, and cells of the Syncfusion React Pivot Table component. I also showed you features like resizing, grid lines, selection mode, clip mode, and cell templates. You can download the working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use all our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.